Well, hello YouTube, it's your girl Jhonae coming at you with another video, and as you can tell by the title, this video is going to be about my favorite fall fragrance combos.
Ooh, I like that.
So if you guys are interested in seeing what combos I have about six of them, then go ahead and just keep on watching. All right, y'all, so first things first, stop what you're doing, stop, and leave me your scent of the day down below. I would love to know what you guys are wearing today or tonight whenever you are watching this video. Also, if you are new to my channel, hello again. My name is Jhonae, welcome. And if you're returning, thank you so much for clicking back onto another video. I truly, truly appreciate you guys' support. I really do. We're on the road to 10K, so if you have not already, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below and hit that thumbs up button if you want to see more videos from moi. Now let's hop into this video because I have some goodies. With that being said, we're gonna hop into my scent of the day. So this combination is just so amazing to me, and it's literally taking the best of both fragrances and combining them into one. And so my scent of the day is Casablanca from Swiss Arabian, layered with Passoir from the House of BDK. I'm gonna start off with Casablanca, go into Passoir, and then I'll talk about them both in conjunction. So Casablanca is a fragrance that I give to myself for my birthday, and I'll leave my birthday haul up in the eye in the sky so you guys can check that out. But this scent is one that I really wanted to try out for over a year, and I finally have it. So this fragrance is a sweet, fruity, slightly powdery, woody, musky, balsamic fragrance. It's absolutely stunning. This also has a little bit of like fresh qualities to it as well, but I wouldn't categorize this as a fresh fragrance. To me, it's just, you know, what I described it as, like a woody, sweet, fruity scent with some balsamic touches and a little bit of woodiness. Oh, it's so beautiful. So on the top, you get some apple, and then going into the mid, you get some woody notes, you get some patchouli along with some iris. And to me, the iris adds that powdery quality to it. The woodiness from the woody notes also comes through as well. And the patchouli to me isn't a dirty patchouli. I think this just adds some depth to the fragrance. I think it does add a little bit of earthiness, but not too dirty. And then in the base, you get that sticky, gooey, delicious caramel along with that resinous amber and pearl balsam, and you get some musk in the base as well. So you get that muskiness from the musk, you get that balsamic quality from the amber and that pearl balsam, and then you get that gourmand sweet touch from that caramel. And the caramel to me comes through almost in the very beginning of the fragrance, like when you first spray it, but you do get a blast of that green apple. I think that I smell kind of like a smokiness as well, because this has suede in the base, and so to me that kind of adds like a smoky, I don't want to say incensey quality to it, but it does add like a smokiness, which I really, really enjoy in this scent. It adds that nice rich depth that I really love in this scent. So when this is layered with Passoir, it literally sets this fragrance off. And Passoir is a fragrance that I really, really love as like a signature scent. I don't have a signature scent, but this is one that I definitely can see someone wearing year round for all occasions. This is work appropriate. This is appropriate to go on a date. This is appropriate for pretty much any occasion, in my opinion. And that's just me. This to me is a very sexy scent, but it's not doing too much. It's still elegant. It's still sophisticated, but it's still flirty in a way, and I really, really like that about this scent. So to me, Passoir is a beautiful woody, fruity, sweet, floral, spicy scent with a little bit of muskiness to it. This also has a bit of a citrusy quality to it as well, but to me that warm spiciness really gets me in the opening, because this has notes of black pepper along with some ginger and some mandarin. So the spice from the ginger and the black pepper really mesh well with that mandarin to me, because that mandarin gives the fragrance like a fresh citrus element. And then when the fragrance starts to dry down in the mid, you get some beautiful quince. It's so juicy and delicious and ripe. It's so beautiful, along with some orange blossom and some jasmine. To me, the jasmine is not indolic whatsoever. It's more of like a sexier jasmine. It's more of a darker jasmine, but it's not overly dark to where you can't wear this in the daytime. The orange blossom also adds a little bit of a sweet floral quality to the fragrance as well. And then the base, y'all. The base really does it for me. You get some cashmere, some amberwood, along with some patchouli. So you get that woodiness. You also get that smooth, rounded quality from that cashmere, and it kind of makes me feel like I'm like getting hugged hugged. It's very cozy in my opinion. And then that patchouli adds some depth to the fragrance, a little bit of earthiness as well. However, when I layer the two fragrances, they just literally like just play off of each other so well. They both have similar vibes without being the same. So both of them have fruity qualities to them. Both of them have woody qualities to them. Both of them have patchouli. And they both kind of have like a suede-y, cashmerian, like smooth element to them, which is why I feel like they work so well together. So for me, I find that Casablanca adds more sweetness to Passoir. It also adds a little bit more of like a gourmand touch, but Passoir adds a little bit more of like a spice to Casablanca, which I really, really love. And when they both dry down, you get that suede with the caramel and the amber, along with that amber wood and the patchouli and the musk. It just works so well together. I just really, really love these two together. And they just smell amazing. They really make me feel sexy, but not like I'm doing too much or that I'm trying too hard. This is more of a sexy, like, you know I smell good, I know I smell good, and I know you're looking at me. You know, like, that's the vibe that I get. It's very confident, but it's not too abrasive. Like, I think that this is a beautiful combination that's not over the top. So if you have both of these fragrances, I definitely recommend you trying them out. If you have, like, Casablanca and you want to try Passoir, I say go on Twisted Lily and get you a 2 ml sample. I do have a discount code with them. Shameless plug. But just try it out because it's a beautiful, beautiful combination. So I have Casablanca from Swiss Arabian and Passoir from the house of BDK. Beautiful combination, and this is my scent of the day. So this next combination is like my bold combo. This is the combo that I don't really wear for compliments. It's more of the combo that I wear to make a statement. Like if I'm trying to be like a bad girl, like I think Rihanna would love this combo. When I think of Rihanna and like her Rated R album, I think of this fragrance combination. It's sexy, y'all. It's really sexy. And this fragrance combo includes Fragrance Du Bois Milano and Kaoli's Vanilla 28. Like this combo for me, it just does it. It does it. It's so beautiful. I absolutely love this combination. Since I have a dedicated review on my Kaoli fragrance collection, which I'll leave up in the eye in the sky, I won't go into too much detail about Vanilla 28, and I've talked about this scent so many times on my channel. And Milano is making its debut, so I'll go into a little bit more depth about this and I'll kind of speed through this one. So first of all, I want to thank Fragrance Du Bois for sending me this scent. They are not expecting me to review this fragrance or anything like that. This video is not sponsored. They just kindly sent me this fragrance a few months ago, and I'm so grateful for it, and I was really able to try this out, and now I have a beautiful combo for you guys. I know this scent is very expensive, however, comma, this scent is absolutely stunning. If you love leather and fragrances, but you love like a sweeter leather, this will be perfect for you. For those of you who watch my channel who like more masculine leaning fragrances, this is definitely that. However, I do think that this scent is very unisex. I really enjoy unisex fragrances, but I also enjoy very feminine scents. I don't have many masculine fragrances in my collection or male targeted fragrances in my collection, but this scent is definitely one that smells amazing on men. I had my brother-in-law spray this on himself when he was here, and he smelled incredible. Like, he smelled amazing. So to me, this fragrance is just a very beautiful leather fragrance, and it has like this warm, spicy quality to it. It also has some fruitiness, it has this sweetness, and it also has like a blast of citrus in the opening. And this also has like an aromatic quality to it, which I find very interesting. So in the opening, you get a lot of saffron, and to me, saffron can kind of get confused with oud, because a lot of the times oud and saffron are used together in fragrances, but saffron is just a very distinctive, very warm, spicy fragrance. And then this also has a note of thyme, and that thyme adds that aromatic, slightly green quality to the fragrance. It adds like this green freshness, but it's not overly green whatsoever. And you also get a little bit of bergamot as well in the opening. And then in the mid, you get some olibanum, you get some fruity notes along with some jasmine. And to me, the jasmine is not indolic whatsoever. It is a bit more of like a fresher jasmine. It adds like a little freshness to the scent, but it's not overwhelming, which I really love because I'm not a fan of like very fresh florals. But the fruity notes really overpower, and it really comes up to the top after about 10 to 15 seconds of this fragrance being on the skin. The fruity notes really come through and adds a lot of sweetness, which I really, really like. And to me, that makes the scent a little bit more unisex versus leaning a bit more masculine. And then in the base, you of course get a ton of leather. You get some amber, some woody notes, some vanilla, and you also get some musk. So overall, this scent to me is just a beautiful scent. Like I said, it is leaning a bit more masculine, but the sweetness from the vanilla, the fruity notes, and the amber really help this fragrance become a bit more unisex in my opinion. I feel like like if it didn't have that sweet touch to it, it would definitely be more of a masculine scent. And I'm not a leather fan whatsoever. I only have a few fragrances in my collection with leather, and this is one of the most predominant leather fragrances. But when I tell you, I let this sit on my skin, and this is the type of fragrance that I would spray about 30 to 45 minutes before I leave to go somewhere, because I want the dry down to really show out. And this fragrance is a beast. Like, this scent, you only need a few sprays, and I'm definitely an over sprayer. Like, if you see my video on my spray routine, I definitely go in like 20 plus sprays. This scent, I can't spray more than 5 times, and that's me being completely honest. That's why my bottle looks virtually untouched, because this scent, you do not need a lot at all. Typically I do about 3 sprays of this, and then I go ham with Vanilla 28. And actually Karina Waldron, if you guys don't know who she is, I'll link her channel down below, but I'm 99% sure almost all of y'all are subscribed to her. But she talked about this fragrance in a live, and this was actually before Fragrance Dubois reached out to me, and she talked about this fragrance, and I was so interested in this, and that's why I ended up choosing this fragrance when Fragrance Dubois reached out to me. And I'm not disappointed, you guys. This is definitely a bold scent. If you are an individual who likes more feminine scents, you won't like this at all, so go ahead and just forget everything that I said. But when it's layered with Vanilla 28, it definitely adds a little bit more of a feminine gourmand touch to it. So if you own Vanilla 28 and you want to try out Milano and you're willing to try a bold combo, I definitely say get a decant, try this out, or get a sample, try this out, and you will really, really love the combination, especially if you spray a few sprays of this and then go to town with Vanilla 28. I also think that Karina spoke about this combo as well, but when I tried it for myself, I was like, yeah, I definitely need to let my folks know what's the tea, because this is what's up. Like, I love these two together. And Vanilla 28 is just a beautiful vanilla fragrance. It's just more of like a vanilla extract. It's a sweet, beautiful, warm, delicious, gourmand scent. It's absolutely stunning. It also has a brown sugar note, and I think that that adds to like the warmth and the sweetness. But overall, I just get a vanilla extract with some sweetness. So vanilla extracts can be very bitter, but this is a sweeter version, which I absolutely love. So these two together are definitely a stunning combination. And again, this is my bold combination. Very unapologetic. That's what I get with this combination. So we have Fragrance Dubois Milano, and we have Kaylee Vanilla 28. This next combination is my sexy combination, but it's a little bit more on the cozy side. So if you want to be booed up, if you want compliments on date night from your boo, this is the combination for you. Ooh, bars! I didn't even try. So this combination is gonna be Cloud Intense from Ariana Grande along with Born Aroma from Valentino. You guys, I love this combination, and I think I posted this on social media as well. I'm not 100% sure, but I think I did. I don't know them. Maybe, possibly. But you guys, I'm just gonna talk about these individually, not in too much depth, because I've talked about Born Aroma so many times. I know y'all are probably tired of me talking about this scent, but I'm gonna talk about it just in case you're new to my channel. And I have a whole dedicated review on my Ariana Grande Cloud Intense, so I'm not gonna go into too much depth about this because y'all need to check that out if y'all haven't watched it. Okay. So I'm going to start off with Born Aroma, and this scent, you guys, is just a beautiful, fruity, woody, sweet, floral, musky scent. This also has a heavy dose of vanilla, which I absolutely love, but in the opening, you get a blast of black currant. That's that juicy fruitiness that you get in the opening. Sometimes it can kind of come off as blueberries, but in this scent, it's very black currant-like, in my opinion. But if you first smell this scent, you're going to be like, that's like a beautiful, delicious fruitiness. You also get some bergamot along with some pink pepper. The pink pepper adds a bit of spice, and the bergamot kind of adds freshness to that sweet, juicy fruitiness. And in the mid, you get some jasmine along with a tea note. And for me, the tea note kind of adds like this calming quality, which I love. And then paired with the jasmine, it's just stunning. To me, the jasmine, again, is not indolic. That's typically not what I go for. And then in the base, you get some vanilla, some guaiac wood, along with some cashmerian. And as I mentioned earlier, cashmerian to me just smells like a hug. Like, it feels so cozy and soothing, and it adds this smooth roundness to the fragrance. The guaiac wood adds a bit of a woody quality to it, and some people say that this scent is a little too masculine, and I think it's from that guaiac wood, but I find that the guaiac wood just adds a bit of like a sex appeal to the scent. And the vanilla, of course, is vanilla. It's not too cakey or too doughy, and this is actually a fragrance I think you can wear year-round, in my opinion. But this fragrance is stunning on its own, and when it's layered with Cloud 2.0, child. I used to layer it with the original Cloud, but when 2.0 came out, I was like, Let me try it with this, and I'm so happy. To me, this scent is just a beautiful, sweet, lactonic, slightly woody scent, and it also has some muskiness to it as well. And I really, really like this scent a lot. You get some freshness from the pear, along with some lavender in the opening. That also adds a little bit of a calming factor. And in the mid, you get some beautiful whipped cream, along with some coconut and some praline. And in the base, you get that ambroxan, along with some woody notes. You also get a bit of musk as well, along with that cashmerian. And as you can tell, both of these fragrances have similar notes, especially in the base. It has like that muskiness, it has that woodiness, it has that cashmerian, and I find that both of the scents together are just stunning. I find that Born Aroma does add a lot of longevity to Cloud Intense, because to me this still isn't a beast mode scent, but it projects a lot more than the original. However, I do find that the whipped cream, the praline, the coconut adds this slight gourmand touch to Born Aroma, along with this creamy lactonic scent. I absolutely love the combination of the two. It's very sexy. It's sexy in a more boot up way. You know, you're really not trying to make a statement, but you will. However, this combination projects like crazy. It's very long lasting. I really enjoy wearing these two together. I'm just so happy to have them, and I think you guys should definitely try this combo out. All right, y'all. So this next combination is my gourmand combination. It's a sweeter combination. I need to hurry up because I have to go to class. So if it seems like I'm rushing, I am. So this combination is going to be Zara's A Sweet Pastry and BDK's Tuberous Imperial. I know I already talked about BDK, but I really like this combo a lot. I also posted this on my social media. A Sweet Pastry is one that's actually sadly discontinued, but it's still a beautiful scent. This is just a sweet, citrusy, vanillic fragrance. It has this doughy quality to it as well. It's absolutely stunning. I truly enjoy this scent. This only has three notes listed, which are lemon, sugar, and vanilla. And to me, the vanilla adds this like doughy, pastry-like quality to it, but a ton of sweetness. Some people describe this to be like a lemon cake, and I definitely can see that as well. This is definitely like very cakey and just delicious. However, when this is layered with BDK Tuberous Imperial, it just sets this fragrance off. Okay, sets it off. This scent to me really just screams elegance. It's so beautiful. It's so creamy and smooth and delicious. Actually, my girl Maria, aka It's MJ, put me onto this. She raved about this scent, and I was like, you know what? I need it. I need it now. To me, the tuberose in this scent is very creamy and buttery and very delicious. It's so beautiful, along with that vanilla that's in the scent as well. But in the opening, you definitely get a ton of white florals. They are heady. I don't like the opening of the scent whatsoever, but I love the dry down. So on the opening, you get some geranium, which kind of adds a bit of like a masculine touch to me, in my opinion, kind of like an earthy quality. And then in the mid, that's when you get that jasmine, you get some iris, along with some ylang ylang, and of course you get that beautiful tuberose. But like I said, it's a very heady blast in the opening. It's like you get all of those mint notes at once, and it's kind of overwhelming, but once you let this dry down, it definitely becomes more of a smooth, sweeter, beautiful scent. And then in the base, you get some cashmerian, you get some incense, you get some benzoin, along with some vanilla and plenty of other notes. And I find that these two together just work so well. I think that A Sweet Pastry just adds a ton of gourmand qualities. This scent already has this like buttery sweetness from the tuberose, and the vanilla and the benzoin is so beautiful, but A Sweet Pastry just really adds that gourmand touch that I love, because I love gourmand fragrances. So this is like my gourmand yummy combination if I want to still smell elegant. So yummy, so beautiful, and I think that this is definitely a beautiful combination for fall. So I have Zara A Sweet Pastry along with Tuberous Imperial from the house of BDK. This next combination is one that's pretty prominent on like Facebook groups and things like that, so I didn't come up with this combination, but I wanted to share it with you guys because I absolutely love it. And I have By the Fireplace from Maison Martin Margiela and Baccarat Rouge 540 from the house of Maison Francis Kurkdjian. So I'm gonna start off with By the Fireplace, which is just a beautiful woody, vanillic, balsamic, spicy, warm, delicious, nutty scent. I really, really love this scent a lot. It literally smells like you're by a fireplace roasting marshmallows, and it has like a nuttiness to it as well. So like maybe you have some toasted chestnuts as well. It has this like smoky, woody quality. A lot of people are turned off by that, but I love it so much. The first time I smelled this, I was a little bit taken aback. You get some clove, some orange blossom, and some pink pepper in the opening, so that's where you get that warm spiciness from. The orange blossom kind of adds a little bit of sweetness as well in a floral way. And then in the mid, you get some juniper, some guaiac wood, and some chestnuts, and that's that woodiness that comes through. You get a little bit of the aromatic quality from the juniper, and then you get that nuttiness from that chestnut. And then in the base, that's when you get that cashmerian, that Peru balsam, along with that vanilla. So you get this smooth, well-rounded, balsamic, vanillic quality. It's so beautiful. The vanilla definitely adds a ton of sweetness to the scent, but it's not overly sweet. I think that Peru balsam adds that smokiness to the scent as well. And it's pretty delicious. I would definitely say this is like teetering towards a gourmand, but it's so smoky and woody that I would think that this is more of a woody scent. Baccarat Rouge 540 is one that a lot of people don't like, honestly. And I understand why. It's very popular. It's very infamous, dare I say. But all in all, this scent is just a beautiful, sweet, woody, slightly aromatic. It also has like a fresh quality to it as well. This scent to me, when I first smelled it, it did have like a medicinal quality to it. But over time, I really don't smell it anymore. I just get this beautiful sweetness. But on some people, they say it's very fresh on them. So I think it just depends on your body chemistry, how your skin reacts to it, maybe what you even moisturize with. I feel like the notes on this fragrance really doesn't do this scent any justice at all, because I don't think that this scent smells like any of the notes really. I think I do get a little bit of a floral take. I also get a little bit of a woodiness, but this claims to have saffron in the opening, and I don't smell saffron whatsoever. But I do get a ton of ambergris. To me, ambergris kind of comes off as like salty skin, but this has a ton of sweetness, so I don't get a ton of that saltiness. This is very resinous and balsamic though, so I do find that this does have like a sweet resinous quality to it. So I think that if you enjoy balsamic resinous fragrances, you will really love this scent. But it just depends on how it reacts on your skin, because if it does go into a fresher route, you may or may not like this. And if this goes more on the sweeter side, you may or may not like this either. But these two together just adds a beautiful combination of smokiness and sweetness to the other fragrances. Baccarat Rouge 540 is very long lasting. So is By the Fireplace. And this is an Eau de Toilette concentration, which is crazy to me. But these two together just really complement each other. They kind of balance each other out. This to me is a very cozy, warm, smoky scent. And I love wearing this on very rainy days. So this is my cozy, warm scent. If you're by a fireplace, if you want to watch spooky movies, be cuddled up, that's exactly what this combination is. So this is By the Fireplace from Maison Martin Margiela, and this is Baccarat Rouge 540 from the house of Maison Francis Kurkdjian. Okay, so we're on the last combination. I hope my battery does not die, so I'm gonna really speed through this. I'm gonna take my time on one of them, but I'm not gonna take too much time, okay? And this next combination is another gourmand combination, but this is for my coffee lovers. If you enjoy coffee scents with some sweetness, you are going to love this combination. It is a bit expensive, but just hear me out. Hear me out. So this combination is Minuit Demi from the house of Fragrance Dubois, layered with Cognac Cafe from Galleria Parfums. I'm gonna start off with Minuit Demi, and then I'm gonna go into Cognac Cafe. So I have a whole dedicated review on Minuit Demi. I'm gonna link that video up in the eye in the sky, so I'm gonna kind of blast through this part so I can talk to you guys more about Cognac Cafe. But this scent is a beautiful, sweet, spicy, woody scent. This also has gourmand touches as well, like caramel and vanilla. And this also, of course, has coffee with some booziness. I'm not gonna go into depth about my actual review, so if you wanna see my actual thoughts, every single thing about this fragrance, from shipping to how it smells to how it wears to compliments, just watch that video. This scent is just stunning. I really like it. I did purchase this when it was first launched. You get notes like coffee, you get caramel, you get some smokiness, you get some cinnamon, so you get some spice and all of that good stuff. So my camera ended up dying. What's new? But I got a new battery, so we're gonna just like nothing happened. So Cognac Cafe is just a beautiful scent. This is just a beautiful, sweet, warm, spicy, woody, coffee, nutty, slightly powdery fragrance with a load of vanilla. This also has a resinous quality to it as well, which I really love. This fragrance is a fragrance that I wish the opening lasted a bit longer, but it doesn't discredit the whole fragrance because it's absolutely beautiful. So on the top, you get this very interesting accord of coffee steam. Like if you were to sit over the top of like a coffee maker and like the steam of the coffee hits you in the face, like I picture the coffee steam kind of blowing at you like aggressively, but it smells so good. It's like not too harsh to where this is like a black coffee steam. It's very light and it's airy, but it has that coffee in the background. It also has like this warmth to it, which I really love. You also get some almond in the opening along with some brown sugar, so that just adds to the sweetness. It gives this nutty quality, and the almond in this fragrance does not go cherry to me. It's very much so a true almond, and it has this very stunning, nutty quality. I really, really enjoy the opening of this fragrance, and I'm so sad that it kind of dies down after a bit. It kind of lingers, but it's not as intense as it is when you first spray the fragrance. But in the mid, you get that cognac accord along with some sandalwood, and you get a note of African coffee absolute, which I absolutely love. So I think that this scent does become a little bit more unisex, slightly masculine in the base, because you get that cedarwood, and you also get a note of barrel of cognac, so I'm assuming that's like the woody, boozy quality, and you get some amberwood, some vanilla, and myrrh. So the myrrh, in my opinion, adds that balsamic, resinous quality, and I do think that this scent is unisex, but I do feel like the dry down leans a bit more masculine, but that vanilla sweetens it up a little bit. But I think that if you enjoy scents like jazz club, those boozy, woody scents, you would love this scent. So Minuit Ademi also has like a liqueur note. I think it's rum, but these two together are stunning. I really enjoy both of these fragrances together. They really make a beautiful combination. They both have coffee. They both have gourmand touches. I find that the spice from the pimento and the cardamom definitely adds a different twist to Cognac Cafe. And also the caramel, the tobacco, the rum, they just work so well with the amberwood and the brown sugar and the nuttiness from the almonds. And you also get that cognac note along with that coffee. They just work so well together. It's just a beautiful, delicious, spicy coffee lover's dream. But the combination of them both just makes me feel so delicious and slightly bougie, like if you want to keep it a buck. Like I really feel so confident when I wear this, and I feel like I know I smell good. I love wearing this combination when I'm at home, cozied up, watching Hocus Pocus, because it's fall. I love watching Halloween movies and just family movies and just things that remind me of fall. And this is definitely a beautiful fall combination. So this is Minuit Ademi from the House of Fragrance Dubois, along with Cognac Cafe from the House of Galleria Parfums. All right, you guys, so that's all I have for you today. I'm so sorry about my camera dying. Goodness gracious, but I'm happy I had a backup, so that's great. But if you enjoyed today's video, please, please let me know down below. Let me know some of your favorite fall combinations, because I would love to know, and I would love to try some of them. So let me know down in the comments below. And if you are new to my channel, I do quiz you guys at the end of all of my videos just to see who's been rocking with me until the end or whatnot. And today I want you guys to leave me the pumpkin emoji for fall. So leave me the pumpkin emoji so that I know you guys made it until the end. And I really hope you guys enjoyed today's video again. And I cannot wait to see you guys in the next one, because we have some exciting things coming. I love you guys so, so much.